This Medical Minute, sponsored by Avera.
It is not as common as breast cancer or colon cancer, but about 94,000 women were diagnosed with gynecologic cancers between 2012 and 2016. That's according to the CDC.
Sam Wright spoke with an Avera gynecologic oncologist about what to keep in mind in this Avera Medical Minute.
So Dr. Starks, how common are gynecologic types of cancers for women?
So gynecologic cancers compared to, say, breast cancer or colon cancer are much rarer. The numbers tend to be smaller. I think that's why they're maybe not always in kind of the public eye or public consciousness. But as like a prime example, with this being Cervix Cancer Awareness Month, there's about 14,000 new cervix cancers diagnosed on a yearly basis in the United States. And obviously that's also due to the fact that we've got a screening program that has dramatically cut the incidence of something like cervix cancer compared to over the last 50 years, really. Some of our other cancers, like an ovary cancer, there is no good screening modalities for the general population, as opposed to, say, breast cancer with mammograms or colonoscopies for colon cancer.
Any habits or lifestyle changes that would help minimize the potential of developing this?
So for cervix cancer, obviously one of the things that people can do, aside from considering the HPV vaccine, at least between the years of 11 and 26, and participating in pap smear screening, obviously better sexual health or using something like condoms can certainly help reduce risk. Avoiding high-risk sexual behavior is also, I think, very important. And stopping smoking is a major thing that some patients can do to cut their risks of developing precancerous lesions.
For more information, head over to avera.org/medicalminute. We'll be right back.